For decades, the aircraft carriers have represented the pinnacle of the United States naval power. They are considered by the defense experts as the single most valuable sea-based assets, and offer an incomparable military apparatus, with ability to project power tactically and strategically at long ranges for a long period of time. The air power that an aircraft carrier brings to the operational area is not only limited to the tremendous capabilities which the assets of an air force can deliver, but at the same time brings massive firepower such as ballistic and cruise missiles from the escort and support ships that sail along with aircraft carriers as part of a carrier strike group. The United States possesses the world's most powerful navy that operates nearly a dozen aircraft carriers, which is more than the next three powers combined. But despite this impressive firepower in the seas, the US Navy has continued to build more and more powerful aircraft carriers that would sail the oceans for the next five decades. The USS Gerald Ford is the largest and most advanced aircraft carrier in the world. After few delays because of the much-needed technological innovations, its construction began in 2009 in the Newport News shipbuilding, and was completed in late 2016. The USS Gerald Ford sea trial began in early 2017, and its final shock trials were finished in 2021. It is expected to enter into active service by mid-2022. The USS Gerald Ford can attain a top speed of 32 knots, and regular speed of 30 knots on high seas. Its layout is similar to the Nimitz-class carriers, with an island on the starboard side, it has an angled flight deck, and has four catapult ramps to launch aircrafts. The Ford-class aircraft carriers have a displacement of 100,000 tons when fully loaded, and is approximately 1,110 feet long, just slightly smaller than its predecessor the Nimitz-class. The USS Gerald Ford can accommodate 2,600 sailors, which is 700 fewer than Nimitz-class carriers. This reduces the crew workload on the deck and create more space for equipments instead. It also carries a small detachment of Marines to carry out search and rescue operations. A single unit of the USS Gerald Ford-class aircraft carrier cost around $13 billion, which is $3.5 billion more than the cost of Nimitz-class. The USS Gerald Ford is powered by two AB1 nuclear reactors manufactured by Bechtel Corporations. Together these reactors can produce 600 megawatt of power, which is three times higher than what the Nimitz-class carriers were producing. The 600 megawatt is enough electricity to cover all the needs of every household in entire New York City. Yet the Ford-class carriers will consume all that power alone. It will need this much power not only to attain its estimated top speed, but also to keep the sensors, radars, and the new electromagnetic catapult launch system operational, which of course consumes tremendous amount of power as they generate powerful magnetic fields that could accelerate the aircrafts to attain its maximum takeoff speeds. From the power attained through nuclear reactors, the Ford-class carriers are propelled through water by four large bronze propellers, which provides it with the top speed of 32 knots and regular speed of 30 knots. The Ford-class carriers are equipped with electromagnetic catapult system to launch aircrafts from its deck, unlike the Nimitz-class carriers, which were using the traditional steam catapult system. This new electromagnetic catapult launch and recovery system using a new advanced arresting gear mechanism to land aircrafts on its deck. It uses a water turbine and induction motors to halt the momentum of landing aircrafts. It is more reliable than the aircraft arresting wire system operated by the Nimitz-class carriers, and is expected to extend the service life of aircrafts by up to 5%. This system is easier to maintain in general and is capable of generating 25% more sorties as well. In terms of sensors and radar, the USS Ford is equipped with the most advanced radar systems in the US Navy's surface fleet. It is equipped with the new dual-band active electronically scanned array radar systems. The dual-band radar system is developed for the Zumwalt-class destroyers and Ford-class carriers by Raytheon. The dual-band radars are X-band and SPY-3 multifunction radar and S-band volume SEER radars. These radars are mounted on the top of its island for better area coverage. However, the island of Ford-class carriers are kept smaller by replacing 10 radar antennas with single six-faced radars. Since this new system of radars has no moving parts, that's why its maintenance and operational requirements are very low as compared to the radar systems of previous class carriers. For self-defense purposes against incoming anti-ship ballistic and cruise missiles, the Ford-class carriers are equipped with a layered defense network of medium and short-range missile defense systems. The Gerald Ford aircraft carrier carries two launchers of evolved Sea Sparrow missile, which is a medium-range defense system. Each launcher of it contains 8 evolved Sea Sparrow missiles. Its operational range is 50 km, and can fly at a speed of Mach 4. It is guided by terminal active radar homing guidance system, and can change its course mid-air as well. The Gerald Ford will be equipped with RIM-116 short-range missile defense system as well. The RIM-116 is a small, lightweight surface-to-air missile, guided by active infrared homing guidance system. Its operational range is 10 km, and is primarily designed as a point defense weapons to shoot down anti-ship cruise missiles. Apart from missile defense systems, the Gerald Ford aircraft carrier will be equipped with Phalanx close-in weapon system as well. The Phalanx SeaWiz has a 6-barrel 20mm radar-guided Gatling gun that can fire up to 4,500 rounds per minute, with effective operational range of 1.5 km. The Phalanx SeaWizes are the last line of defense for Gerald Ford aircraft carriers and any other surface combatant it is deployed on. The Gerald Ford aircraft carrier air wing will consist of fighter aircrafts for both offensive and defensive capability. It will carry two squadrons of the 5th generation F-35 Joint Strike Fighters, two squadrons of F/A-18 Super Hornets, 5-6 AR-18 Growlers for electronic warfare capability, 2-3 Hawkeye airborne early warning aircrafts, as well as a number of helicopters for different purposes. Defense experts suggest that the F/A-18 Super Hornets might be replaced in the near future, and the air wing of Ford will form entirely of the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter. The Gerald Ford aircraft carrier will also be carrying the MQ-25 refueling and intelligence collection drones once its extended trials are completed. The USS Gerald Ford has completed its final shock trials, and will enter into active service in mid-2022. Its entry into service will once again will raise the US Navy's carrier force to its mandatory level of 11 ships. The US Navy is planning to replace its current fleet of 10 carriers with Ford-class aircraft carriers by 2050. Even though China currently possesses the largest navy in the world, but its fleet mostly consists of small and outdated surface ships. However, more recently China is closing the quality gap with the US Navy as well, as it is now building state-of-the-art destroyers, frigates, nuclear submarines, and aircraft carriers at an alarming rate. That is why the US Navy is currently pushing hard to build and maintain a 350-ships navy to counter China in Pacific Ocean generally, and in the first and second island chain specifically. That's all on the topic for now. Make sure to subscribe our YouTube channel for more videos and updates. Take care and have a great day.